Sea level rise hasn't affected her home yet, and she's not worried about it becoming a problem in the future.
The projections, some of them are pretty grim, though. Is that something that worries you at all? No? Yeah.
This is the scale of the task ahead. The huge waves yesterday tore through the defenses the railway relies on.
We will be the first people to wipe out from this earth.
Clearly, sea level rise is both a fascinating and a frightening subject. As scientists, here is what we do know about it. But let's start by saying that adapting to sea level rise isn't exactly new for humankind. Roughly 120,000 years ago, for instance, sea level was 10 meters higher than today and the ice sheet smaller. And only 20,000 years ago, it was around 125 meters lower than today because the water was stored as ice in two massive ice sheets. But while moving a camp wasn't a big deal for our ancestors, moving today, Venice or New York, is a different story. This very high social risk of sea level rise to human coastal settlements is the reason why more than 100 scientists from 26 institutions in Europe are currently working together in a new project called PROTECT to better predict sea level rise in the future. Within the project, we're discussing with stakeholders across the world, asking questions like, can we build this hospital on the coastline or not? And how should we build it? Back in the 90s, honestly, we thought sea level rise due to human-induced climate change was rather straightforward to predict. The first IPCC report was considering the ice sheets like something changing very slowly, like over many hundreds of years. Today, and we saw it with our own eyes and measurements, we know that the ice sheets can change much faster. 2014 saw the first IPCC report taking the ice dynamics into account, but with still very high uncertainties for the future. Depending on whether we are doing business as usual or if we are finally taking all this seriously, then clearly sea level rise won't be the same and we might be, or not, able to adapt. We could also enter a non-reversible state in which whatever we do, the ice sheets are lost. So where is this water coming from? Well, not from the North Pole, since it's just sea ice. And sea ice, melted or not, just like an ice cube in a glass, won't change sea level. The water is actually coming from all the land ice on Earth. Glaciers, the Greenland ice sheet, and most of all, the Antarctic ice sheet, which alone holds enough ice to cover the whole world under 58 meters of water once entirely melted. Pretty mind-boggling. Currently, if we do not follow the Paris Agreement and don't reduce our greenhouse gas emissions, sea level rise could exceed 1 meter during the second part of the century. It may sound like nothing, but it's not. According to a study by the World Bank, this 1 meter increase could cost up to $18 trillion just to protect populated coastal areas worldwide, and our economies are not ready for that. But how do we calculate how much the sea is going to rise? With loads of discussions, calculations, and fun, within the scientific community, yes, but also with models using data, satellite images, and a bunch of computers. The idea is simple. We put together physical equations to model the ice sheets with all their dynamic aspects, and we use the data from the past to calibrate our models. When the model successfully managed to reproduce the past, then we consider it might be able to predict the future. What we do in PROTECT is to run many different institutions' models all over Europe to give a much better understanding of reality. However, science is also a lesson of humility, and we know there are things that we do not completely understand today, things we are likely to discover in the future, like some new processes we haven't included in our models yet. To continue this voyage into the intimate and quite unusual world of sea level discoveries, stay tuned for episode 2.